Hello and welcome to another tutorial from CamiPaige Boutique. I am Brooke Tannehill, and today I am so excited to bring you a whimsical version of a Halloween Witch's Cauldron Tumbler. This cup was so much fun to make, and all of the different elements make it perfect for any Halloween celebration. As always, all the products I use will be listed in the description below, and you might even find a coupon code to save you some coin. Also, huge news, we just launched our brand new Facebook group, so check out the link below to take advantage of a bunch of upcoming freebies and giveaways that you are not gonna wanna miss. So without further hesitation, let's go ahead and get started. Prepped True 22 from the Steel Magnolia, and I grabbed a neon pink spray paint from Montana Black. Now, I am using this spray paint, but I have to say I don't recommend it. I don't get great coverage and it comes out as a powder, but for what I was using it for, it was okay. And I also started with the light pink or the neon pink spray paint instead of what I traditionally do with like the rims of the cup, because these nozzles do not have any direction to them whatsoever. I mean, you can kind of see here that it just sprays every which way. So I'm just trying to really coat the center of the cup well and lay the groundwork for the pink and purple ombre that we'll be doing on this beautiful cup. And then I grab my trusty gloss grape spray paint from Rust-Oleum, and I just spray the bottom of the cup, focusing on kind of, if you think about the cup in thirds, the bottom third and then the top third, blending the colors as much as possible. And really, again, like the spray paint is laying the groundwork for the glitter that you come in with after this step. Now, you don't have to necessarily 100% stick to exactly where the spray paint is laid down, but it is a very, very nice guide point for when you're laying those beautiful glitters over the top of the cup. One thing I do want to call out is kind of how I'm blending the purple colors into the pink. I'm just doing very short little bursts of spray paint and lightly laying down, I don't want to call them layers, but just like little spurts of paint to get that blend that I'm looking for. You don't want to hold the nozzle down because you'll just get drips and it just will not look nice. So here you can see I got nice fades. There's no drips and we're good to move into the next step. I'm going to use the epoxy method to apply the glitter to this cup, and I actually did this during a live in the A Little Extra Ink Epoxy group. So that's what you're seeing, that's why the screen looks a little bit different. But what I do for the epoxy method is I always mix up at least 10 milliliters of epoxy, let that sit for about 1 to 2 minutes, and then pull the epoxy up the cup. Now, I do not dump the epoxy on the cup. What you'll see is I just dip my gloved finger, very, very important, my gloved finger into the epoxy and spread it over the top of the surface of the cup. The reason why I don't just dump it on the cup is because you want as little epoxy on the cup as possible. You don't want too much, because what happens then is you get pooling of the glitter and it will cause discoloration, and you actually lose quite a bit of the sparkle if you have too much on there. Now, I'm going to be using a chunky glitter mix for the purple, so I do use a little bit more epoxy than I typically would just because of the chunky. But when I say a little bit more, I mean like I went from 1 milliliters to maybe 1.5 to 2 milliliters. The first glitter I'm using is called Free Spirit from Glitter Heart Company, and I don't even know how to explain the amazingness of this glitter. I love it because it has so many multifaceted cuts in it. And because of that, you don't have to come over the top of it with a finer cut of glitter to get that full coverage. This glitter covers every bit as much as you've ever wanted it to and more. And it's a color shifting glitter that just adds such a beautiful sparkle to the cup that this is literally, I can say, my favorite glitter from Glitter Heart Company. So again, it's called Free Spirit. And what I'm doing to get the ombres is I'm starting at the very bottom rim of the cup and just letting the glitter cascade down into a little bit into that pink. So letting it just cascade, create that blend, even though we haven't started with the pink glitter. So sorry, I'm like awkwardly talking in this video, but I promise it made sense on the live. And then I go into the top rim of the cup. And again, I'm just lightly sprinkling, letting the purple start to cascade into the pink and lay the groundwork for that pink glitter. So I had a little bit of an issue where I let the purple glitter get a little bit ahead of itself and get further into the pink section of the spray paint. So I just wiped it off with a paper towel here, but I recommend a baby wipe. Came in with a little bit more of a little extra ink epoxy and laid that base layer of epoxy down for the adhesive. So again, I am never afraid to show you when I am on the struggle bus with my cups, because I think we can always learn from them. But yeah, so here I'm just coming in, applying a little bit more epoxy, and then getting ready to move into the beautiful neon pink glitter. The pink I'm using is called Pretty in Pink from Glitter Heart Company, and I really like it because it's almost fluffy. I know that's probably not a great descriptor for glitter, but it just has a really nice texture, and it just cascades over the cup wonderfully and blends perfectly into the purple that I've already laid down with the Free Spirit. I also like it because it has more of a subtle shimmer to it under epoxy, which was perfect because there were so many different elements going onto this cup that it wasn't overpowering and complemented everything else that we had chose to put in this design. After I've gotten all my glitter laid down and I'm happy with the blend, I take a gloved finger and just push down any of the spiky bits that could be sticking up because of the chunky glitter mix. This is just a highly recommended step because it allows you to get that flat surface for the next coat of epoxy to go over, and it requires less sanding and less epoxy overall by just taking a couple of minutes by pushing down the glitter. I let the cup dry for about 3 or 4 hours, and then it was ready for its first coat of epoxy. Now, before I went into epoxy, I did spray the crap out of this cup. So I used Rust-Oleum 2x Clear Gloss Semi-Spray Paint, and I loaded this cup up twice, so two different layers, to make sure that I didn't have any movement of the glitter when I went into epoxy. This is really, really important, especially when you're working with two colors that are so they just contrast so much with themselves. So highly recommend sealing your cup. Then I mixed up, I want to say about 35 milliliters of a little extra ink epoxy. And the reason why I did more than I typically do is because, well, there's two big reasons. The first one, that this is a 32 ounce cup. And the second was because we are trying to cover all of that beautiful chunky mixed glitter. And that always takes a little more epoxy when you're applying it this first round. Also, this coat required two coats of epoxy before moving into this next step that I'm showing you. And you also want to take time to make sure that you sand the cup to get a smooth surface before applying this amazing 3D element that is the Witch's Cauldron. This cauldron was actually 3D printed in my basement, and it is made out of a plastic material, and it is cut specifically to the dimensions of the true 22 cup. Now, if you're interested, please feel free to reach out to me, because I can get this cut to any diameter or matching any cup that you're utilizing, and I can get those printed and sent out to you. So I'll list those details below. But what I want to make sure to do is paint the 3D cauldron with acrylic paint. The reason why I'm using acrylic and not something else is because its thicker texture, or viscosity, you can say, really works to fill in some of the linear, like you get lines in a 3D print. This really fills those in. And you also want to make sure to take your time and do probably 2 to 3 coats, waiting for about 20 to 30 minutes between coats. And the reason why, you can actually see it right here, is the paint almost absorbs into the cauldron. Not because the plastic's actually absorbing it, but there's a bunch of holes between the lines of the filament that was used to print this. So the acrylic paint absorbs into those lines and creates that wonderful smooth surface. So I'm not the most eloquent when it comes to painting the cauldron, but make sure that you're doing at least like 2 to 3 coats to get full coverage in that beautiful deep black color. The next thing I'm doing is prepping the surface of the tumbler to adhere the cauldron to. So you actually want a scuffed up surface for the epoxy so that the adhesive that you use to attach the cauldron really has a surface to stick to that isn't just slick and has it run off. After you scuff it up, what I did is I sprayed it down with alcohol and wiped it down. I made sure that the cauldron fit the way I wanted to and I had it in position. Then I grabbed just a simple super glue and I made sure to put enough of it close enough to the edges, but not too close to where the super glue would come out from underneath the cauldron when you pushed it down and have the chance of having that white glue adhesive show after it had dried. So just cover the cauldron with the super glue, and I just pushed it down and made sure that I liked the way it was placed, it was straight, and it wasn't going anywhere. One of the reasons why I chose to use super glue instead of like E6000 or some of those other ones is because it dries so quickly. But I did let it sit for probably a good, I want to say 6 hours, just to make sure before I moved into the next step, which I'm showing you now. I will say I had some learnings when it came to epoxying the cauldron, but I love that I only use a little extra ink epoxy because you'll see, especially in the finished pictures, just how beautiful the shine is and the clarity of the epoxy that allows this cauldron to truly come to life. I also grabbed a silicone brush, and the tip on it is just a normal kind of pointed silicone brush, but what it allowed me to do is to make sure I was getting good epoxy coverage underneath the handle of the cauldron, but not too much to where you have that wonky pooling that really takes away from a design sometimes when you're doing these 3D elements. So take your time, make sure that you have good coverage, but not too much on the cauldron, and then make sure that you're also adding another pretty thin coat to the rest of the cup so you have really good adhesion of the cauldron and something for that layer of epoxy to stick to around the entire cup. Also, for this layer of epoxy, I only used 25 milliliters, and that was plenty to give me a really nice coat. Then it was time for water slides. So I printed this design off on Hippo water slide paper, and I'll list it below. And I use this really cute bat design. So I've actually uploaded it in my Facebook group. So if you're a member, you can download it for free and recreate this design. But I sealed it with the triple glaze from Krylon. And I'm sorry if I mentioned it wrong, but I will list it below. And I just printed it off, sealed it 3 times, letting it dry for about 30 minutes between each layer. Then I just put the cute little bats in a bowl of probably lukewarm, but more on the warm side water, and just slid the little water slides down and applied it to the cup. Water slides are pretty easy to use, but if you have any questions, please feel free to reach out. But just applied it to the cup, and then I make sure to smooth it out, get all the water out from underneath, and just use a paper towel to kind of tap it dry. I then let them dry for about a good 30 minutes to 45 minutes until we can move into filling the awesome cauldron. So the way I decided to fill this cauldron was with a mixture of supplies. So the first one I did was hot glue. Now, the reason why I chose hot glue instead of puffy paint for the whole thing is hot glue is cheap. Like, it's super cheap. You just have to pay for the glue. And what I did first was kind of lay that base for the bubbly evilness to come out of, or the green goo and slime, whatever you want to call it. So I just filled the bottom of, or I guess it's actually the top of the cauldron, as much as I wanted to lay the groundwork for where I would like to see the bubbles. And then I got these really cute little half pearls from Amazon. And again, they're listed below. And I just started placing them every so often in the hot glue. And I'm sorry I'm out of frame. It was actually really hard to kind of video this, but all you want to do is just lay down some wet hot glue, and I know it's super hot when it's wet, but and just place the different bubbles into them. So, and by bubbles I mean half pearls. There's no rhyme or reason. It's whatever you like. I decided to bring the hot glue up on the cup a little bit to make it look like the bubbly gooiness was bubbling over the side of the cauldron, but you can simply keep it here. And then I even decided to add a couple of little glops of the goop on the front of the cauldron also to kind of symbolize that the potion was overflowing, so to say. Something else I really liked about the little pearls is that there was a bunch of different sizes. So I started out with the bigger half pearls just to kind of get the bigger bubbles, and then I used the tinier little pearls to fill in the spaces to make it give it different bubbly goodness bubble sizes to the goop that we're doing. Once I was happy with how the half pearls were placed and I got the bubbliness coming up on the cup, I grabbed my neon green puff paint, and what I did was I started to outline the bubbles. Now, since we use hot glue, there are going to be strings places just because it is the nature of it, but just do your best to remove the strings because they will show up on the design. I actually like to use my X-Acto knife and just cut them off and try and round the edges because I could simply cover them up with this puff paint. But all I'm doing is going around the bubbles, I guess we could call them, or the half pearls, and also filling in any of the spots that would be the goopy goodness of this witch's cauldron. Now, take complete artistic license on this. If you want more of the green goopiness and less bubbles, by all means. If you really want to build up the green puffy paint for the potion that you're using, absolutely do it. This is art, this is your cup, and I swear whatever you create is going to be absolutely beautiful. But one thing I will call out with the puffy paint is you do want to let it fully dry. Come back to the cup and make sure that there aren't any little spaces that didn't dry the way you wanted, or if it pulled apart and there's some empty crevices that you need to fill in again. I did that to the cup probably about 2 or 3 times just to make sure that I had the full coverage. Then here, what I did is I also came back a second time and I applied more pearls into the puffy paint. This was just to give it more, I guess, visibility to the bubbles and fill in some of the spots that got completely covered with the puffy paint with the pearls to really keep the aesthetic that I was going for with this cup. Once I was happy with the top of the cauldron being filled in with the puffy paint, I moved to the actual body of the cauldron, if you want to say. So this is the goop that dripped over the edge of the cauldron onto the black part. And I wanted to show you here that if you don't want to use the hot glue, or if you find some place that you would prefer just to do the puffy paint, you absolutely can. That's what I did here. I thought that it needed a little bit more to help balance out the design. So I just put a glop of puffy paint down and then attached the pearls, and they stuck wonderfully. Just as well as the hot glue. So don't be afraid to do that either if that's what you desire. When I was done with the puffy paint, I thought it needed just a little bit more to the cup. So I found these super cute witch's potion vinyl decals, and they are actually, again, for free, or they're listed for free in my Facebook group. I cut them out of this amazing green color shift holographic vinyl and applied them to the cup. And the reason why I chose green is because I felt like it matched the color of the goop that was coming out of the cauldron, and it was just a great little added detail. Now, it wouldn't be one of my tutorials if I wasn't sealing vinyl. So this is just a polyurethane sealer. This one's specifically from CC DIY. But you can see I don't have the cup spinning, and I just put a little bit over the top of the vinyl, rub it in, and I let this dry for about a good 45 minutes while it's turning so that we can move into the next step, which is epoxy. For this final coat of epoxy, and since we had sealed everything so well, it only needed one, I mixed up 30 mls of a little extra ink epoxy and just applied probably, I would say like a medium, it wasn't a flood coat or anything like that, but like a good medium layer of epoxy, and it came out so wonderfully. So I just made sure to spend some time on the top of the cauldron, as you see here, and also with my little gloops to make sure that they are covered, but not too much, again, that you do not want the pooling. And I also made sure that I didn't get too much epoxy under the handle so that you do have that weird kind of clear space where epoxy got underneath it, and just it kind of detracts from the overall design. But that was it. I let this cure for about, I think it was pretty much dry within 6 hours, not fully cured because that takes 3 days with ALE. But I mean, the shine was just absolutely amazing. I didn't have any bubbles on the cauldron because that was one of my biggest concerns with it being just so flat black on this pretty intricate design, but it was amazing. And oh my gosh, you guys, take a look at this. I actually had the hardest time trying to photograph this cup because it was so shiny. I seriously, it has the best shine because of the ALE epoxy. It was so sparkly. It was really hard to capture all of the dimension and the design details, but I am so happy with how it came out, especially for it being my first 3D tumbler. And just so you know, this cup was actually created as part of a challenge. I am in the Patreon group for Made by Maddie and Mal, and the challenge for this month was Neon Halloween, and I am very, very proud of my submission. As always, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. It really does mean the world to me. As always, if you like this tutorial, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe so that you don't miss out on any of my future videos. Also, hit the bell button so that you get all of your notifications. Thank you so much for watching again. I cannot begin to express my gratitude, and I hope you stay tuned for the next one. Love you guys. Bye.